How you doing, you lovely people? You ready to have some fun? We'll be right back. Hello. How are you doing? Are you feeling okay? I've got a bit of a sore wrist, but let's not talk about that. I've been playing a lot of guitar over the last few days. Should we go to the homepage? Let's say hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, 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 hello. How are you doing, everybody? If you're on the front page, then welcome in. Lovely to see you. Hey, my pals. Hey, Dusty Music. How you doing? Hey, Jimmy Neutron. Hey, Karen Morbis. Hey, the unfortunate one. Hey, Rico Stench. Rico Stench is in the house, everybody. Qued Fito, my mod, is here, my main mod. That's good news for everyone, guys. And Harmony as well. Harmony's in the house. What's up, my pals? Nothing much. My left arm and wrist is a bit achy. I've been doing quite a lot of session work the last few days. I was meant to stream on Monday and Tuesday, and I just had to take a couple of days out to get some jobs done. I had to do a couple of tracks and a massive medley track, which, you know, companies will always want that stuff yesterday, bless them, which is fair enough. And but there was just a lot of work, and I thought, by the time I finished working, I just thought, you know what, I need a shower and some sleep and everything. And I thought tonight, yeah, okay, let's do the Wednesday night 9 o'clock. This is me at 9 o'clock. It's 9:34. Can you see? This is me at 9 p.m. In my head, I'm on time. That's me. Say hello, everyone. Greet yourself in the chat. Say hello to everyone, and make yourselves known to each other, and have a good chat. And I'm going to do some more instrumentals, and keep it. We're going to start out chilled. We're going to start out chilled, folks. We had a mammoth 6-hour stream. I've got to tell you, right? YouTube blocked one of the time videos, right? They usually allow it. But this time they decided to block one of the videos, right, from when I did Dark Side of the Moon, right? And, by the way, we smashed 1,000 subscribers on YouTube as well. Thank you very much, guys. I think that's mostly front pages, but thank you very much. Still need 4,000 watch hours, but there you go. It's all right. We're getting there. I have a video that's probably going to come out later in the year that will do that, so hopefully. And YouTube didn't allow it, so what I had to do is I had to... Because it was a 6-hour video that I VOD'd from Twitch to YouTube, I thought, oh, that's okay, I'll just trim out the segment. Ineligible. Ineligible to trim it out, because the video's too long. So I've got to download the video from Twitch, right? All 14 gig of it, right? And then edit out 40 seconds, because that's the only bit they blocked. Why not block the whole song? If I do this, right? If I play that riff, bam, bam, down, 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 yeah, Radar Love, YouTube blocks it, but it only blocks the riff. So if I talk over it like this, and I just say everything like this, and I do it like this, Audio Magic doesn't pick it up. It's utterly, the whole thing is ruined. The whole music system is broken, with a capital B. Really is, guys. So bear with me if you look, because three of you wanted to know where the VOD was from Sunday night. And it's there, but it's blocked. I can't release it, you know. So I've got to edit it in Adobe Premiere, or whatever it is I use. Adobe Premiere in Vegas I use, both of them. And then upload it to YouTube. We're starting a revolution, Dusty. We certainly are. I don't mind companies. I don't mind the artists, for example. If I do a cover of Hotel California, God help you if you cover Hotel California. All right. Anyway, if I did a cover of Hotel California and I want to put it on YouTube, it will mostly be because... It will mostly be because the people that have seen me play live in this area where I live will want to see me on YouTube, for example. I see little harm in that. Also, I don't mind the artist getting all of the royalties if I make any royalties on it at all, which I won't. I don't mind sharing. I don't mind them having everything. They wrote the song. Don Felder and whoever wrote the song, you know, the Eagles wrote it. So why block it? Why block it, you know? So the lesson is, don't do six-hour streams and try and transfer them to YouTube. Because especially if you're doing Pink Floyd, Pink Floyd love to block. They have got powers beyond belief. They can shut down your stream even on Twitch if you do it. So anyway, it's not going to stop us because we're going to have fun. I think I can see a big long username popping up in the chat. It's just got K. All I can see is a K, a P, an R, and a J. Sorry, that must mean that Kenny's Prog Rock Jukebox is in the house. Can you just change it to Kenny's Place or Kenny's Music Bar or just K? That'd be easiest. Can you just have K as your username, like K? Did I forget my glasses? I don't need glasses. I don't wear glasses. I'm all right. Cred Fito, but it wouldn't get blocked if it was my playing. It would sound nothing like it was intending. Do you know what? It's the videos that they don't like. It's not the audio. It used to be when I remade that Dark Side of the Moon. And I uploaded it to YouTube. I made a video out of it, and I thought, oh, sod it, just try it, see if it gets blocked. And it was all the videos that were blocked. And the audio segment that was blocked was the money at the beginning of Money, where Roger Waters is tipping coins into his wife's pottery thing, bowl, or whatever it was. Or however he did it, right? And... over the years, it gets worse and worse. Then it was blocked. Then the audio was muted. Then the audio was allowed. Then the video was muted. And it went on and on. It's the same with the Purple Rain video. For about a year and a half, you couldn't see the video. You could just hear the audio. And then, all of a sudden, the video was allowed and the audio was blocked. And it's like, you know, I'm sorry, guys, but the only way you're going to beat piracy is to offer the price of the software or the music for less than the price of the medium. And unfortunately, there is no medium with the internet. It's tangibleless. It just floats around the ether, you know? What is the internet, Neo? It's just one computer linked to another. That's all it is. I'm having a bit of a rant here. Phil Smythe Music is in the house. Hello, struggling with rubbish hotel here. I'm not much mod use tonight. That's all right, Phil. However, I've fixed your Farmer Phil as well. We've got new ones. And if I can find them here, look. Here's the main one, look.
Hello, me lovers!
But I didn't like the tractor field, Phil. So what I've done is on the actual performance scenes, I've actually put... I put this, okay, so if I just put this in, look, this is the new one for you, Phil. There you go. Can you see? And there's no sound, he just pops up and goes, hello, me lovers, and you come off again. All right. Okay. Only us could do it. Hey, thanks for the follows. Thank you so much indeed. I better make some music because I think we're on the front page again and it's going to be another one of those crazy evenings, I think, guys. Hence why I'm doing a mixed bag tonight. But I've got a bit of a sore. I'll be doing session work for the last sort of 48 hours, like virtually non-stop.
And hello, me lovers!
Phil's still there. What's going on? Hold on a minute. Let me turn him off. There you go. Let me turn him off. So my wrist is a little bit, I may have to put my wrist strap on. Yeah, I've got this wrist strap. I think they're brilliant. When I had really bad wrist problems in 2010, I wore these things and within about 3 months, 2 months, my problems completely disappeared. Frozen screen, oh no. Never trust Wi-Fi. When I started streaming, I used the Wi-Fi. Luckily, it wasn't anything public, but it was just a nightmare. best thing I ever did was get myself a Switch. Cred Fito recommended that. So I've got a Switch. So we've got one cable coming from the main LAN from there, and I've wired it all the way round into here, and then that goes in and comes out to 7. So I've got it, all the computers, even the laptop, everything is all LAN'd up. And the only thing that isn't is the phone and the tablet, which the tablet uses WebSocket anyway. And the other, these is all MIDI and scripts and hotkey scripts and stuff. So yeah, definitely I hate Wi-Fi. I used to love Wi-Fi, but now I've seen the light. Thanks to Cred Fito. Let's do another instrumental, guys, okay? And if you are on the front page, can we just get the shout out for the front page, please, mods? My mods tonight are going to look after you here. First of all, can we have a shout out for Phil Smythe Music? Second of all, can we have a shout out for Kenny's Prog Rock Jukebox and the Jukesters? Give them a shout out. Go give them a follow. They're superb. They're brilliant. We love them in equal parts and equal quantities. And I recommend them wholeheartedly. I also recommend a ton of other people. I'm going to have to get a list, a scrolling list of people I recommend. We need, you know, hopefully Pete Northcote will pop in so I can give him a shout out as well. Did you see his concert the other night? It was bloody brilliant, wasn't it? I caught bits of it, you know. He's a legend, that man. Thank you, guys. We're on it. Thank you. Okay, let me just have a jiggle and then have a hydrate and then we're going to get on with it. Yeah, hi, the unfortunate one. How you doing? Yeah, Pete is a legend. I love him. Absolute legend. He plays how I aspire to play, like, which is just like a classic rock guitar player with a smattering of like a classic sort of Michael Schenker-y, Jimi Hendrix-y, Vai, Satriani, all the great lead players all rolled into one, but like not too much widdly, 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 widdly. And loads of melodic content and really good bending and intonation. And that's what I aspire to be like as a guitar player. Because as much as I do all that wiggly stuff, it's a bit messy sometimes because I get too overexcited. And so, yeah. No, he's not. Stop fishing for compliments, Kenny. We love you equally as well. T-Turtle Blues, how you doing? How you doing, mate? T-Turtle Blues, thank you so much for the other night for messaging Karen in a whisper and making her feel when we got raided by Spaceman. I owe you one, fella. That was nice of you. That was a nice touch. Thank you very much, T-Turtle Blues. Big shout out for you, fella. If you're a gamer or a streamer or a musician, can we have a shout out for you? Even if you haven't, just give him a shout out. But, you know... Thanks so much, T-Turtle Blues. Thank you. Really appreciate that. Because Karen was a little bit, whoa, what am I going to do the other night? And we kept on getting raided and we were on the front page and it was just bonkers. So, much appreciated. Okay, it's looking like we're getting up to about 84 people. And I never get 84 people. So we're definitely on the front page somewhere. So let me just, I better start playing some music for you guys. Let me do some Steve Vai and let me do some Jeff Beck. Okay, so I'm going to do Steve Vai's Answers from Passion and Warfare and then we're going to do for Jeff Beck, The Pump. Okay, so let me just do a couple of intros. We'll be right back. Let's stay with some instrumental. This is Light Years Away by Joe Satriani. Come on, people, let's rock it. We'll be right back.
The shred is strong with this one.
What we were saying before, Dusty, that song's in the key of G minor. So what rules the roost in keys, especially when it comes to modality, because of equal temperament, what rules the roost is whether the third is flattened or whether it's major. The two most important notes, Kenny will tell you, because he's been to Berkeley, the two most important notes in a chord are the third and the seventh. They're the two most important notes. You can omit the fifth. It's not needed. It's very rarely needed, you know? So in that, for instance, in that one, it's G Dorian. So as soon as I hear the word Dorian, I know it's a two of something. That's it. So I know it's the second mode. So I know it's just F major from G to G. But I also know that I can use D minor pentatonic. I can use A minor pentatonic. I can use G minor pentatonic as well. And I can use C7 arpeggios. I can use D minor arpeggios. So I'm mixing them all up. And I'm trying to do them in a sextuplet thing, like a widdly, 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 widdly run, like that. And I'm trying to keep that rhythm going. And I'm just playing shapes. I'm just seeing notes on the fingerboard. And I'm thinking, oh, I'll go there, I'll do that. And that's, you know, I hate to break the, if there's any magic down, but that's really how I play. I like that unlocking the guitar neck. If you go to my website, there's a thing on there called the unlocking the guitar neck. And it's a thing when I was teaching years ago at colleges and universities, when I was on the adult education classes and stuff. I used to do this thing where I talk about unlocking the guitar neck. And it's a really, really useful. I may do a chat and jam on it one evening. But it's really good, because what it does is it forces you to... It's free. You get it from my website right now. And you print out all the sheets. And you follow it through with your chromatic interval chart and stuff. And you start circling out notes on the neck. You start circling out all the shapes. So for chords, if you do that with major, you're going to see the cage system. You're going to see the C shape, A shape, G shape, E shape, and D shape. But you're also going to see that if a teacher tells you to play a C major there, then forevermore, until the ends of time, you'll only ever know that a C major is there. Whereas if you see all the notes on the neck and C, E, G all over the neck, that's a C major. That's a C major. That's a C major. That's a C major. And it's up to you. You can have that choice then. So when you see a chord progression or a song, you have the power to say, okay, I want to do that. I want to play that way and that way. And then you can keep the chords closer to you in position, so you're not moving about all over the neck. Like that, like Nirvana. Now that's something to be said. I'm glad I mentioned Nirvana, because a lot of people used to run his guitar playing down. But I actually thought he was actually quite a good guitar player, because I never saw him look down at his guitar neck when he was playing. Not much. So he had a good feel. He knew where to go, you know, like for In Bloom, Lithium, etc., and all them tunes, you know. And there was, he always knew where to move to. So there's something to be said. There's a technique in every level of guitar player. There's a technique. I am a hopeless, I'll make no bones about it, I'm an absolutely horrific, horrific acoustic guitar player. I'm terrible. I can play acoustic guitar, but I just hate it. I love watching other people. Phil Smythe is brilliant at it, where he just gets his mate on acoustic, mini acoustic, and he just gets a beat going, and he's just brilliant. He's just great, and I wish I could. I so want to be like that. I think, oh, I could get an acoustic guitar, I could do that, but I hate acoustic guitar. I absolutely loathe it. I love watching Ed Sheeran. I love watching James Taylor firing. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Oh, my God. That live version is just stunning. And, yeah. And I've got an acoustic guitar, and it's got a lovely Fishman preamp in it. It's a beautiful guitar. Well, it's a cheap guitar, but I've modded it to hell. And the action's nice and comfy, you know. But still don't like it. And I think for me, especially like, because I've had to do a load of session work the last 2 days, and it's just been most of my session work will involve an acoustic guitar. So I literally add another naught on the end,
because I hate it so much. I want to actually lose the job than not get it, because I hate playing acoustic so much. I hate them. They should all be burned. They're brilliant as fire fuel, acoustic guitars. They're really good. Whereas electric guitars and playing lead guitar, I love. I love the freedom of saying I've just got one note, as if I was a solo instrument like a saxophone or a clarinet. And I've got one note and I have to make the melodies and I can target the chord tones. Next song I'm going to do is a classic example of that. So if Dusty and people out there are watching, so that I'm going to do Knocking on Heaven's Door, okay? And so we know the chord progression, G, D, A minor, or G, D, C, G, D, A minor, and it alternates G, D, C, G, D, A minor, right? So I know I've got G, B, D, D, F sharp, A, A, C, E, G, B, D, D, F sharp, A, C, E, G. I know, and I see the notes changing on the fretboard where I can go. And then I can now think about timing and phrasing, hopefully. And over the years, a solo, the main solo that I do is the same one, and it's crafted from about 10 years of being solo or more, where I've cooked up this solo, and it's come about from, you know, the division bell, Pink Floyd, when it goes, take it back, and it goes. And Gabrielle's Rise. I know you're a dreamer. There you go. Listen out for those tags when I play this song, and you'll hear them in there. It's because I take inspiration from vocal lines as well. And I think, I really like that vocal line, I'm nicking it. And if you listen to Gabrielle's Rise, it's exactly the same chord progression as Knocking on Heaven's Door. And if you hear me do Purple Rain at the end, you'll always hear me do this. Yeah, Seven Wonders of the World, I think Fleetwood Mac, when he goes, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, right? I always put that in Purple Rain right at the end. Always. And it's because it just reminds me of when I was in Belgium going on a school trip and I had nothing but Fleetwood Mac Tango in the Night on my Walkman. And I absolutely fell in love with the new Fleetwood Mac, as much as I love the old Jeremy Spencer era of Fleetwood Mac. So, yeah, that's it. And you'll find all these little mnemonics, these little bits, mostly because I really desperately want to be a jazz player. That's what I really do, because I felt so inadequate when I was at college, because these bebop guys were just like that. They were just amazing. And I picked up a few things, like Wes Montgomery's like 4-on-6 and tritone substitution. And I tried to pick up some lead lines from Django Reinhardt and people like that. And I'm just a failed jazzer, you know. And I try so hard, but I'm never. I'm just a grungy teenage grungy rocker. That's really all I am, really. So anyway, what we're gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna do Knocking on Heaven's Door now. Okay. No, I didn't, Kenny. I didn't see your message about the mix, mate. Sorry. I'm just checking my messages. I don't have anything from you, buddy. So after my stream, I'll check it. I'll definitely not check it during the stream after what happened last time. I just wanted to give people a bit of prep, because there's some people asking stuff on my theory section in Discord and stuff, and I'm a big lover of music theory. So I just thought I'd just say, so let's do Knocking on Heaven's Door, okay? Thank you. Mama, take this badge away from me. But I can't use it anymore. It's getting dark, too dark to see. And it feels like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Cause it feels like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Thank you for the raid, guys. I guess I'm knocking on heaven's door. Now, Sheriff, take these guns away from me. Welcome in, Raiders. But I can't shoot them anymore. There's a long black cloud that keeps following me. It feels like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Cause it feels like I'm knocking on heaven's door. I guess I'm knocking on heaven's door.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that backing track as well. It's with my late friend Mick West. He used to write a lot of backing tracks in the 90s. Pretty much, I would say a third of the backing tracks that you see on Amerits or karaoke version, probably less, maybe less than that, maybe, were done by him. He sold a load off in the late 90s, the MIDI master files, which are the golden goose, really. That's where I make most of my money, is on the MIDI master file sales. And so, yeah, so he's using old Yamaha XG sound module for that. And when he passed away, I thought, you know what? I'm not changing that backing track. I'm keeping that the same. I could update it with modern plugins, and I kept it the same. So, you know, I don't care. Listen, you know. So let's do one of my own numbers. Let's move over to... hey, Just Rob Hound Dog. How you doing? Nice to see you. Thanks, Dusty Music. Thanks, Musical Cure. Good to see you. Psychoface 1991. Thanks for the follow. Thank you so much indeed. That's very good to see you here. Breezy, how you doing, Breezy Breezy? Sorry, Breezy. I'm sorry. I always get your name wrong. I'm in so much trouble. I'm so sorry. Let's do one of my own tracks. This is let's start with Time Traveler, and let's work up to heavy stuff, you know? Okay. So it is a Wednesday. I usually do my SF Live stuff, but I'm going to be mixing it up while they're smattering me on Twitch front page, okay, guys? So okay, so the next song is Time Traveler, title track. It's one of my own.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, people. Let's stay with the Time Traveller album and let's do a song that's the fourth track, I believe, other than Lost in Time. So I think it's going to be Doors of Light. Jimmy will correct me because Jimmy's got the album probably in front of him. This is Doors of Light. It's a bit more proggy. If Kenny's there, this is a bit more proggy. Whoa. I'm delving into Kenny territory here. Hang on a minute. He still won't like it. He's a hard man to please. Well, I love him dearly. I'm only joking, of course. This is Doors of Light. We'll be right back. Oh, yeah. This is your fave, Jim, Dust and Flames. Yeah, you're right, track four. Sorry, buddy. Thanks so much, Dusty. Let's go right back to the Alive album. I want to do one of my favourite. This is Miss Wiggle's favourite as well. This is called Signs. Thank you.
Those notes were mostly right, but mostly in the right order, I think. The biggest problem with that song is it was written for piano, and if you're just playing dyads, blam 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 like that, it's easy. But I thought, oh no, I know what. Let's do it on the guitar, but do it linearly where you've got to slide all the notes. It's easy when you're sitting down, and I forget, and I really like the music video. I thought, oh, let's do signs, and as soon as it starts, I think, oh yeah, it's got that complicated slidey bit in it. I never get it right. I'm so sorry, guys. let's do the next track. I'll get this one right. Let's do the next track. This is called Beyond the Stars, okay?
We'll be right back.
Thanks so much, guys. Beyond the Stars, the story behind that, I just finished writing the title track Alive, and which is what those two tracks are from the album Alive. There you go, those two, Beyond the Stars and Signs. And I just finished doing Alive. I was in the studio, and I went up to bed, and I heard boom, 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 boom. I thought, oh, for God's sake, I've been up all night recording this song. Back down I came, got the idea, laid a scratch, just put a little drum loop down and put the idea down and saved it. Like that. I think it was meant to be called Through the Planets or Through Something. It was meant to be called something else, but I was playing an Yngwie song one night, Far Beyond the Star, Far Beyond the Sun, and I thought, oh, I'll just call it Beyond the Stars, that's it. Boom, thanks, Yngwie. So there you go. This next one is called Solitude. And it's from the Overture album.
Bye.
Thanks so much, Gredfito. I stay with that album and do an album that a track that I never really do. I'd say I do it, but I don't do it very often. This is Revolution. Alright, thanks so much. Hey, Mama Jukes, how you doing? Hey, Bryce, are you still here? Thanks for sticking around. Thank you so much. Let's do another track from there. Anyone want to do a bit of covers? Some covers, you know? You know how it is. Let me change guitars and let's do the title track from Alive. This is drop D. Let's get all heavy.
Okay, guys. Slight wardrobe malfunction here. Let me just adjust something. Let me just adjust me lederhosen. Lovely. Okie dokie. This is Alive. I just went to get the guitar, and like 50,000 instruments just went all over the floor, and the cameras are knocked, and it's chaos in here tonight. I love this one. Even if I say so myself. It's Cinema Motes, people, come on!
Thanks so much, guys. Blimey, I look like Jimmy Page there. What's going on? That guitar strap was way too low. Let's do the track, the heaviest track that I have ever written, or ever released, sorry. Because Sign of Nine and One Man and the other, there's a few other tracks off of Another World that are pretty damn heavy that I must complete one day. But off of the current released album, I have Time Traveller, which is the fourth in the series of instrumental rock. Seven Bridges to Cross is the first EP. Overture is the second. Alive is the third. And the fourth is Time Traveller. The fourth one, the heaviest track, is March of the Machines. And I know it's a fave of some of you people, so here it is.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, thank you very much, thank you very much. See some new people, so streaks a lot. Does he really? Oh dear. This guy's talented, got a new fan. Actually, I have got the fan on tonight here. It's just here, got a ceiling fan. It's getting a little bit clement in here. Over here in the UK, if it gets above about 19 degrees centigrade, we start sunbathing and getting the lotion on and stuff like that and start sitting out the back garden. So for us at the moment, I think the temperature's about 15, 16. So I'm starting to sweat and, you know, I've got fans on and there's dehumidifiers being placed strategically in between the leg areas and things like that, you know. It's getting out of hand. So thank you so much, guys. Beavis says, what's he saying? So he says, reminds me of a good Tool Adam chug. Everyone says about Tool. I don't listen to Tool at all. I love them, but I have hardly listened to any of them. But if it sounds like that, I'm sorry. most people listen to it and go, oh, he sounds like Joe Satriani. That's what most people do. I can assure you that it is purely intentional. I do love Joe Satriani a lot. Love the chugging. Thank you so much. Sir Streaks a lot says, brother, you're the man. Love this. Thank you so much. Right, good night all. Have a great rest of the stream and be kind to each other. See you all when you're older. Okay, Dusty, take care. Nice to see you. I'm going to do a few classic rock covers, a few cheesy ones, just to keep things going.
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, live and let live.
You know you did.
But if this ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry, so live and let die. Live and let die. Used to say, But if this ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry, so live and let die.
There's a story behind that pictures. Oh, terrible.
Years ago, my dear friend Pat and Wendy took us to the James Bond Museum in Covent Garden. And I love anything James Bond, hence the song. And thank you, the unfortunate one. Thank you for the claps, guys. Thanks for sticking around. Thank you. And they had this photo booth. Of course, it's like February, so it's, or March, it's like quite cold, which is pretty standard fare in the UK. But it was colder than normal. We're in Covent Garden walking around, we go in, and they take an opportunity so you can have your picture taken in as like James Bond. I'm like, oh my God, you know? It always reminds me of the time when I dressed up like Batman. I'm not going to tell you about that. I love Batman. I want to get me and Phil Smythe, me as Batman and him as Robin, when he gets running, ding, 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 like that, with a green screen behind us like this. Anyway, back on Earth, they said, would I like my photo taken? I'm like, yeah, sure. So I've got my coat and jumper and everything else on, and they put this thing over the top of me. So it makes me look like Go Compare. Makes me look like the bloke from Go Compare. Red Fito, we need a devil horns. Jimmy, you can do it yourself. You are a subscriber and you are a VIP. Bear in mind, subscribers have access to all these lovely commands. They do come up on the screen. You can tap them in. Not now. Everyone does that. And on the homepage, they don't work on the homepage and this page. Otherwise, I wouldn't get a word in. Everyone just be popping up loads of annoying things. Do it when it's far more funny when I'm playing and I'm being all serious and somebody pops up a, you know, Captain Kirk's jazz hands or something, or a Skull Smash, or Farmer Phil. Phil Smythe Music comes along on his tractor. Okay? So, you know, annoy me that way. It's much more fun. Yeah, right, I can't even use it. Exclamation mark, let's rock, Jimmy. Now, let's test you out. Here's Jimmy. Jimmy's like the Dippy of Pete Northcote's. We love him. I love Jimmy. But he's also really skillful as well. Exclamation mark, let's rock. Come on, Jimmy. You can do it. Exclamation mark, let's rock. All one word, lowercase. Come on, Jimmy. Go on. Take care, Brizy. Come on, Jimmy. Come on. He's not going to do it now. Come on, Jimmy. You can do it, mate. We're rooting for you. Oh, I meant instead of clap. Oh, yeah, you can do that. It still comes up. If you do Let's Rock, it triggers Nightbot and it triggers the on-screen command like that. See? And it also triggers stuff in there. You can have double commands in things like that. Right, let's get on with the show. Oh, I want a groove now. See that wall there? See that wall? I want you to fill it with emotes. Fill it with emotes. Come on. Really good emotes. Come on, Harmony. Show them who's boss on the emotes wall. Come on.
We'll be right back.
gonna go to the place that's the best. When they lay me down to die, going up to the spirit in the sky. Going up to the spirit in the sky. That's where I'm gonna go when I die. When I die and they lay me to rest, I'm gonna go to the place that's the best. Woo!
Miss Wiggles in the house!
Prepare yourself, you know it's a must. Gotta have a friend in Jesus. So you know that when you die, he's gonna recommend you to the spirit in the sky. Gonna recommend you to the spirit in the sky. That's where you're gonna go when you die. When you die and then lay you to rest, you're gonna go to the place that's the best. Oh yeah.
Hey, hanky panky. Hanky panky, are you ready for some hanky panky? It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll.
But listen closely.
It's my girl voice.
Not for very much longer.
I've got to keep control.
I remember doing the time war. Drinking those moments when would hit me and the void would be calling.
Come on, Twitches. Hanky panky, it's just a jump to the left. Mama Jukes, put your hands on your hips.
And
It's so dreamy. Oh, fantasy for a quit better job than this. Still you can't see me. No, not at all. With viadistic intentions from another dimension. Well secluded, I see all. With a bit of a mind flip, you're into the time slip. And nothing can ever be the same. You're spaced out on sensation, like you're under sedation. Here we go. There's a little bit of a solo. Jump to the left. Miss Wiggles, put your hands on your hips. Why do I feel like I'm appearing on a weird Black Lace album? Let's keep going.
got to know. Thank you so much indeed. Mooney with his with the worm dance. It's a testament to Phil Smythe for him being such a good sport. We had this conversation a couple of days ago on Discord. We sometimes have a little chat. and I was saying, oh, look at the state of me. Look, I'm overweight. I'm wearing a Jack Daniels ropey T-shirt. I've got long hair. He went, you think you got problems? I talk like a bloody farmer. But we do. You all worry about your insecurity. It doesn't matter. Fat, tall, short, thin, black, white, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. What matters is the music, guys. I'm here to make music. That's my excuse, so pass me another burger. I'm joking, of course. I eat, believe it or not. Tell 'em, Miss Wiggles. She prepares all my meals. I eat very healthily. Thank you, Hanky Panky. Stop laughing. Hey, Edward 5150. Guys, I'm going to take an intermission for like 5 minutes so I can go pee. Yeah, because I've been drinking water. Okay? 5 minutes, okay? So go for a pee, do what you need to do, and we'll adjourn back here in 5 minuets, okay? Is that all right? Well, if it isn't, there's nothing you can do about it. I've got to go for a pee, so all right? I'll see you back very soon, you lovely people, okay? See you soon. Hang on, let me just go to... Hang on, yeah. Back soon. Take care. See you back. 5 minutes. 5 minutes, go for a wee, all right? Let's all go for a wee. Come on, let's all go together. Go. See you soon. Thank you so much for waiting, people. You're a very kind bunch. Oh, that was much better. Had to go for a pee in the poo, you know? Had to just go to the toilet. And I'm back now. Yeah, my Strange Kind of Life album. I may actually do one of my songs off it tonight. I've been burning the candle at both ends. I went to bed this morning at 9 a.m. and then I woke up at about 6 p.m. Because I've been working all through the night on a track for a client, and so yeah. Yeah, the hidden track, Jimmy. Bless your heart. I'm back, hanky panky. I'm back, people. So, I better put a guitar in my hands and adjust me lederhosen. There you go. Let me just give you a recap if you've not been here before. And what I do. My name is Steve Forward, and I'm a guitar player for a living. Can you believe it? I actually make a living playing a piece of wood. Which is amazing when you think about how hard it is to make a living having a regular job. I'm very lucky in that, other people around me help me a lot. I have a lot of help. All this stuff here, like already played and all this stuff and the web cameras and all this, don't happen by accident. And most of it is from my mod. My mod Credfito and my other mod, my other half. Thank you so much for the follow. Karen Morbis has an amazing 1940s feel good wartime show. We should get a shout out for Karen Morbis, please, but we should also show some mod love, please, in the chat if you can, for the mods. Medek's been modding for me recently when it got crazy on Sunday and there was about 5,000, 6,000 people watching me. And tonight it's a very much more subdued. I usually get about 20 or 30 people. So I know I'm defo on the front page, but I'm obviously not high up or in the algorithm yet. And the problem is that you perform and you do a stream for 2 hours or 3 hours. And then right near the end, you get a massive big raid. Or right near the end, your viewing figures go right up like this. It's like, if you could let me know, please, when I'm going to... Then I could go on. No, but I'm feeling a little, just today, I'm feeling a little bit burnt out today. I just love playing for you guys, and I love streaming on Twitch. Me and Karen both, she has her own studio. This is one room, and then in the other room, she has her own studio as well in the house. And so she can stream whenever she wants. The problem is we can't stream at the same time. So we can't raid each other, which would be great, wouldn't it? That would be great to raid. That would be great to raid other people. You know, me other half, it'd be great. I usually do three separate shows on a Monday, a Wednesday, and a Friday. And the Monday one is always Monday. It's just time to jam. It's the Monday blues session, and I jam to original backing tracks that I've written that you can all download for free as well. From my website and use and record over. And there was a band from Canada, a duo, that used my backing tracks. And it was like, they put my name on it, something forward. I can't remember what the name of the album was, but I think you'll find it. It's on my website. I did a little spot on it. And I love things like that. I really do. And then on a Wednesday, like tonight, it's usually all original music, my instrumental rock, no covers. At all. Same as Monday, no covers. I do a few Hendrix jams, but no singing. And Wednesday is no singing either. And then on the Friday, the Friday Night Rock Show, which is what this is a similar thing. This looks exactly the same as the Friday Night Rock Show. On the Friday night, I do the Friday Night Rock Show, all classic rock covers and originals and everything thrown in. And I thought, while they put me on the front page, I may as well combine the Wednesday and the Friday one. So originals and covers. In just this show, which is this one here. It's just my name and what I do, and that's it. That way I can decide to flip between what I need to do. And when it's in, you know, I'm not really a requests guy. Excuse me, sorry about that. I'm not really a requests guy. I'm getting used to it slowly. But if there's numbers that I do that you can see on my, I have a stream of song list !SL. You guys can find it. But I don't really do a queue and all that stuff, because I find that you end up running yourself ragged for like 3 hours doing this like this. And one minute you're doing Slade, the next minute you're doing Metallica, the next minute you're doing Steve Vai number, and you're just like, blimey. So I tend to sort of theme it and block them together. But every now and again, I do open up the request. So that being said, did you do your own graphics, etc., during your songs? Yes. Yes, they're all from Pixabay. So I say yes and no. So there are the videos. There are 20 songs. So White Room by Queen, Are You Gonna Go My Way, The Doors, Riders on the Storm, David Bowie, Space Oddity, Blue Oyster Cult, Don't Fear the Reaper, Steve Miller's Abracadabra, Paul McCartney and Wings, Live and Let Die, White Snake, Here I Go Again, Jimi Hendrix, Crosstown Traffic, and then my own rock version of Tainted Love, Foreigner, Feels Like the First Time, The Cult, She's So Sanctuary, Metallica, Enter Sandman, Deep Purple, Hush, Norman Greenbaum, Spirit in the Sky, Iron Maiden, Number of the Beast, believe it or not, I'm not going to be able to sing that one tonight, and then we've got Purple Rain, and The Time Warp, and The Monster Mash. So those are about 20, it's about 20, 21 actually, there's a few more. How I actually do it is I write the videos in, well, I used to use Sony Vegas, now I use Adobe Premiere, write them in, and then I load the backing track in that I've written, I load it in, and then I make the video to the backing track to the same length. And then I use an auto hotkey command. So when it starts, it puts the title of the track now playing down in the bottom there. And then it sends, I don't know how it works, but Craig Fito, my mod, does. He's the genius. And then it sends a little script to VLC Media Player to start the movie, which is a little movie window there, VLC Media Player. That's the exact length, exact size that fits the screen of OBS. And we've got an auto hotkey script that does that each time. So I don't have to resize the window. I just click a script and it opens up. And then whenever I need the video, I call it up with MIDI chunk command from ShowBuddy. And it changes scenes to suit the video. And it's as simple as that. There's a lot of scripting going on behind the scenes and stuff as well. But I request Bucks Fizz Making Your Mind Up. I hope this works. No. No. I don't do Bucks Fizz Making Your Mind Up. I'm not whipping my skirt off. That's why you never see my waist down in here. So I've got a skirt on, see? So I'm not doing that. Please can you send me a whisper, as I couldn't understand the graphics program Steve said for graphics. Okay, I use Pixabay. It's a website and it's all royalty-free videos. So when I do most of my videos, with the exception of the Pink Floyd stuff where I use Pixabay and some imagery that I've done in Photoshop and some stuff from the Immersion box set, from Pink Floyd's Immersion box set, which YouTube hates, and but I still do it. All right. But yeah, Pixabay, reason why I done that, Hanky Panky, the reason why I wanted to do videos in some of my songs is because you just don't want to stand watching. I want to try and make it entertaining and make it a good show for people, you know, as much as I can do with the gear that I have. The main computer that I use is over 10 years old. It's a first generation i7, and I love it. It just cuts through everything so well. Yeah, thanks, Cred Fito. Thank you. Yeah, you can get some. Get some great footage on there. And if you piece it together, if you find what you're looking for, you may not find exactly what you're looking for. So, for instance, the next song I'm going to do is my own from Strange Kind of Life, Falling Away. Okay, And that was made, all the video footage was made in Pixabay. And I've seen other people use clips of it as well. It's just to get the idea across, to get the point across, and it's just something that's very different that makes it different. That's all. So let me strap on a guitar. Let me strap on a guitar, and we'll do Falling Away from Strange Kind of Life. Because I know Jimmy likes that as well. Windows 95, no. Windows 7. All my machines are on Windows 7. Those three there, and that's on Windows 10. Which I hate. Windows 10 is the worst operating system ever made, other than Windows ME, which was even worse than that. Apart from Credfito will tell you that Windows 11 is even worse than Windows 10. So I don't know what the heck Microsoft are doing. But anything's better than Apple. Trust me, I was an Apple guy for years. And trust me, when Apple go wrong, when you get the sad Mac face like that, that is it. It's curtains. You got to take it back to the shop and wait 6 weeks and like, no. So I build all my machines myself. I build them all. The machine that I built, that I'm lucky in that I know my mod Credfito loaned us a couple of GTX 970 cards last year during the pandemic. I'm very fortunate in that regard. So thank you, Cred. Once again, my mod saves the day. So me and Karen both have each of those cards in our machines. But I'd love to build this year. I'd love to build a new machine, but the idea of the machine that I've got in mind is like something like an i9 with 64 gig of RAM and two RMX cards. It's just because I want to future-proof it and like two M's hard drives and stuff, M2s and stuff. I just want to, you know, because when I built that machine in 2010, it cost me £400, which I thought was a lot of money. But the motherboard is an X58AOC, an overclocking motherboard, and it's meant for competitions, for overclocking competitions. That's what the motherboard was meant for. And I thought, well, most motherboards are about £50 to £80. I thought if I spend £250 on a motherboard and keep it stock and run it stock, it's gonna last really. And sure enough, it did. It's had a few problems over the years with overheating. That's because mainly I've not de-dusted it, and I think it could do with a nice blob of new thermal grease, compound grease on the automatic silver or something on the heatsink of the CPU. But other than that, it runs at about 45, 55 normal load. If I'm streaming right now, it'll maybe touch 61 degrees C. If that, if I'm rendering a movie, it will shoot up to about 80, 85. Sometimes it's shot up to 90, 95 degrees C when I've been rendering a movie and I've had to de-dust it because the dust gets in. Quite a dusty place in here. I don't allow anyone in this room. This is my man cave. Apart from you Twitterarties and Twitch people. So hanky panky, I got iMac and Windows. Credfito, I've junked Windows completely now after using Windows almost exclusively since Windows 2.0. Love these chats. Thank you, hanky panky. Yeah, I like to just do these little talks every now and then. Sometimes I sit down and do them down there. Yeah. Jimmy, I can tell you Cred is a Linux man, a Linux man. He uses Linux. Red Hat, is it? Or the other one? I'd love to go to that. I'd love to have a Linux machine just for streaming when I build my machine. But what I'm hoping to do is I'm hoping to get a 7th or 8th gen, second-hand 7th or 8th gen i7. Mobo motherboard bundle with about 16 or 32 gig of RAM and just whack Windows 7 on it, and I know where I stand then, and then that can just sit down here and be my permanent streaming machine. Because you can pick them up, like the old i7 quads, you can pick them up for like a couple £100, you know. And if you know what you're looking for, I don't really need an M2 drive. I've got SS, they're all solid state boot drives anyway, so I think what I would really like to do is have a rack here and have the main streaming PC with a couple of screens in here and stuff. But it took so long to get to this point at the moment. I'm not really in the mood for changing anything right now, what I do. I don't really want to change anything. Hey, Metallicana, how you doing? Nice to see you in here, mate. We're talking about gear. I should be making music, shouldn't I? Sometimes I do chat and jams where I just sit down and I jam. I don't do any of the
any of the silly nonsense with all the videos and the cameras flying around. People like them. I don't like them when people come in, because I feel like I should be doing the show, the big show that I do, like this one or something, with all the covers and the videos and things. But people don't care. It's just me, my ego, I suppose. What I found, I'll tell you one thing about getting tired. I know it's a trite statement, but what I've actually found is that it's not the day after that you feel it. It's the day after, 2 days after, that you really feel it. And Sunday I did a stream and it was like 6 hours long. I wasn't meaning to do 6 hours. As you can see, the viewers are staying at a pretty healthy 57 at the moment, like this, or 50 or 40. And then every so often, because they put me on the front page, they'll zip up to like 70 or 80, and I think, oh, that's okay. And then every so often I look round and it was like 4,000, and I thought, oh, is that the views? I thought, no, the views, 398,000 views I've had, which are not really real. They're not realistic because they're front pages. Beavis says, feeling it at 55 myself. I'm 46, Beavis. And one of the things I find is that you start getting a dizzy, spinny, and you start getting like tired very quickly, you know. I just got an email from my doctor saying today, your blood pressure's not been done for a good few years. You better come in. I'm like, I'm fine. Lots of rest and water. I'll tell you what, water is the key to everything. Drinking water is absolutely, I drink probably too much, but it's ever so good for you. Water is the key to a healthy metabolism and stuff. And rest. I noticed that when I suffer from tinnitus, I noticed that when I have a good night's sleep, a good solid 8 hours, I wake up and my tinnitus is noticeably, significantly less. And so, yeah. Ah, you're 51, Hanky Panky. Okay. Hanky Panky says, I've got a live YouTube to watch in a min. Other night was crazy. Yeah, that's not on the VOD yet. As I explained earlier to everyone, because it's 6 hours long, there's a segment that YouTube blocked. And because it's 6 hours, they won't let me trim it out. So because I've been busy with session work the last few days, I've downloaded the video, the VOD from Twitch, like 14 gig of it. I've got to open it up in Premiere, trim out the bit it doesn't like, or cut it into 2-3 hour segments, and then upload them up to YouTube so people can watch the VOD of it. If you're a subscriber, you just go into Discord and you've got access to all my VODs, even the cover ones. I make the cover ones for subscribers only. The only reason why I do that is not to be funny. It's just that, you know, I've got to make a living somehow, you know, and I'm trying to get subscribers in. I'm not being rude by that. I just think that I'm not being rude, but I make it free. I do all these streams for free, and the Monday Blues session and SF Lives are all free. But I put these as a surprise stream or C4 Guitarist in the Discord in the restricted section. I hate doing it. I don't like to just give it all away for free, you know. But you know, that's apparently the new business model that works, just giving it all away for free. But is it 4 hours only? No, six. This one's coming up to about 3 hours, and I'm really sort of setting myself a limit now. That if it's kind of like getting to like three and a half hours, and I call it a night. I'm used to doing sets that are like 2:45s or 3:45s, so basically playing for about 2 hours. But I mean, I'm standing up for 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours sometimes. That's insane, just standing in the same spot. And sometimes there's not many people on, so I think, oh, you know what, don't worry, you know, we've done 3 hours, just call it a night. But there's always that thing at the back of your mind, though, there might be a raid any minute, or the viewing figures might go up because they put you on the front page and all that kind of stuff. So see, 65 now.
Do you watch the figures? If you can watch the figures, you'll see, because I've been on there for a while now. It's in the algorithms in the system. And it doesn't matter what I do. I could cut to intermission and just leave it, and the figures would go up. When I took a break, it stayed at 57 viewers. It didn't go down. Was it last on Sunday? I smashed a level 5 hype train, didn't we? And all I was doing was jabbering. All I was doing was talking. So it's nothing to do with it, because people come and go. People think, oh, it's time. Oh, they want to watch something else. They want to do something else. Maybe they got to go to bed. Maybe they got to go and do some real world stuff. And so, you know, half the time it's got nothing to do with what I'm generating and what I'm doing, and everything to do with how other people's lives are patterned out and how it goes around. So excuse me while I fill up my hot tub. Take care, Harmony. Harmony! Lovely to see you. Thank you for putting up my waffle. I will see you guys. Not that I'm finishing tonight. Not yet. Take care, Harmony. Harmony was one of the very first, you'll see her there, she was one of the very first people on my stream, and she's here all the time, every stream. I think she's missed one, if that, and you know, most of you are always here. That's to be commended. Thank you. I really like that. Can others hear you playing live? I don't know what you mean, Hanky Panky. Oh no! We've got fantastic neighbours next door. When the house we got, it's only semi-detached. There's only another house attached to it. They don't hear any of the guitar or any of the backing track or anything. It's going straight into my headphones and then straight out to you guys. And they only hear me singing. So that's it. They just think, oh, it's just Steve singing. But when the lockdown happened, Hanky Panky, there's an interesting thing I'll tell you. I actually set my... If you can go on YouTube and see, I literally had my phone and put it up there and hit record and literally set my PA system up here and did a gig and played and turned it up. And it was quite quiet how I had it, but, I mean, that must have been bonkers. But, you know, when we spoke to the next-door neighbours, she came around and she said, you've got to do what you got to do. It was unprecedented times when it happened as well, the pandemic. None of us could really see that it was going to go that way. You know, that's why what's happened with Boris and Rishi today. You know, they've been fine. They should just get out. They broke the law. They broke the law. End of. There are families that lost loved ones during the pandemic that weren't allowed to visit them. Yet Boris Johnson was allowed to party. I don't want to get all political about it. It's fact. He should just go. And he won't, because he thinks the rules don't apply to him. So, there you go. Me being a little bit political there, sorry. I'm not going to have another debate about that, sorry. Yeah, it just basically goes... the microphone, the guitar, and the laptop, which does the backing tracks, all go into an analog mixer there. and then the two leads come out, the left and right come out, and go into my sound card, which goes into OBS, which goes out to the internet. And if I sit down there, I've got a webcam there, and I can just open up a door, open up Reaper, and I can play my guitar down there as well. I've managed to get that all sorted out now. Thank you very much, Hanky Panky. Let's do a song. We'll be right back. Let's do a vocal song from my album Strange Kind of Life. This is called Falling Away.
Falling. side you see. Supplied through empty streets.
Thank you so much indeed. That was an original, can you believe it? An original vocal song. I've got about another 10 of them. And I'm going to be working my way through the year, putting one more in, etc. I want to put Paradise in, and I want to put Moving Up, and I want to put the one that I wrote about Kylie Minogue in. I'm just thinking maybe I should dress up as Kylie Minogue, do a music video. Stranger things have happened. As I said to you guys, at Christmas time, I am working on Bohemian Rhapsody. And as I showed you all, you guys, how I remade all the vocal operatic section in a past VOD. Excuse me, got indigestion. And I showed people how I was making it all. That's been a long time coming. I actually have plans using this black theatre drop. I actually have plans to do a little. The little sections, the music video sections that they did in the video as well, but don't hold your breath on that, because I'm not putting that out until that is good and ready. What I'm going to do is, if you guys want to help me out on that one, head over to my YouTube channel and just watch loads of my music videos. Just watch them. Just keep them on repeat. Just keep watching them, because. I managed to smash 1,000 subscribers, but I'm not smashing my watch hours at all. So if you just go on there and just watch loads of videos, keep watching all my videos on YouTube, just literally cane it, literally like watch, just leave them on repeat in a playlist or something. That'll really help me out. And that's free to do. Also, smashing the follow button. If you are on the front page, there may be some of you and you've never seen me before. Smash that follow button. Boom, 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 and all that caper. Thank you very much indeed. Makes a difference. If you are back to see me, thank you very much indeed. It's much appreciated. You totally rock, guys. Thank you very much indeed.
Miss Wiggles. Girl, you gotta love your man. Take him by the hand. Make him understand. The world on you depends. Our life will never end. Gotta love your man. Yeah. House we're born, into this world we're thrown, like a dog without a bone, an actor out alone, riders on the storm.
Thank you so much indeed. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I do like a bit of Doors, me. I am a partial to a bit of Doors. Here we go. Turn it up.
Sun or the rain, come on, baby. Baby, take my hand. We'll be able to fly. Baby, I'm your man. La 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 la. La.
Thank you so much indeed, guys. Thank you for the follow. Thank you so much indeed. So Ravenhawk47 just followed me now, and we had Deborah Lopes. Thank you so much for the follow. Audio Rando, thank you, followed me. So Streaks a lot followed me. And thank you for the cheer, 100 bits, Credfito. Zompensky and Psychoface 981, thank you for the raid, Psychoface. And Fishy Food followed me, as well as Happy XCI and FBJ and Planet. Oh, I see. Plate tits. Anyway, and Nick D24 followed me as well. And thank you for all your previous follows as well. Thank you so much indeed, guys. Hola, saludas a todos. Hey, Natri Blood, welcome in. And MLA Format, welcome in. I'm wrapping up tonight now, guys. Okay, I'm wrapping up because I'm exhausted. And a three-hour stream is more than enough. So I'm going to make this the last number, and then we're going to find someone to raid. Thank you so much for watching me. I'm not streaming tomorrow. I am streaming Friday at 9 p.m. for the Friday Night Rock Show. It's going to be a good one. It's always fun. It's going to be a similar show to this. And look out for any impromptu streams that I do. Click the follow button if you've not done it already. And if you have a Prime account, Amazon Prime, then you can link it and you can subscribe to me for absolutely free as well. Details of that, my lovely mods will be in here. Mods, you'll be pleased to know that this is the last number tonight. We'll find someone to raid. And then we're going to do the credit roll. And, you know, so Jimmy, thank you so much. Jimmy Neutron, I appreciate your support. Thank you for being here. Great show. Cheers, Steve, and the mods. Yeah, thank you so much. Once again, go and check out Phil Smythe Music. I know he talks like a farmer, but he's none the worse for it. And it's his good nature and his good, even-tempered nature that lets me poke fun of him and put him in a tractor and put him on my stream. It's a testament to him. So go and give him a follow if you've not seen Phil Smythe. He's a good musician and a good guitar player. He gets my thumbs up 100%, okay? Thank you, Phil, wherever you are. I hope you're doing well. And I will be back Friday at 9 p.m., okay? Now, I know I'm crap with time, but 9 p.m., all right? So between about 9 and 9:30, okay, I will be online, okay? And that's the Friday Night Rock Show. And we'll just keep doing this in between. We'll keep doing these cover mix shows until I'm off the front page, and then I'll be back to doing the Monday Blues session and stuff, or if I decide to switch things around, and I will do. There's a chat and jam coming up soon. I'm going to do a chat and jam where I'm just sitting there and there's no fancy stuff. There's one of them coming up next week, I would have thought. And that's about it. So let's find someone we can raid, and then I'm going to do one last number, okay, guys? Yes, MLA Format. Yes. Glad Phil, I know him. He's a great bloke. Phil Smythe Music is excellent. Yes, go give him support if you can. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much indeed. Okay, really appreciate the support. We are going to do the last number.
I never meant to cause you any trouble. I never meant to cause you any pain. I only want to see you happy one time. And I only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. You lovely people. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Only want to see you bathing in the purple rain. Or I never wanted to be your weekend lover. Only wanted to be some kind of friend. Now, baby, I could never steal you from another. Such a shame our friendship had to end. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. To see you bathing in the purple rain. Honey, I know these times are changing. It's time we all reached out for something new. Well, that means you too. Now you say you want a leader, but you can't make up your mind. Let me guide you to the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain.
You take care of yourselves, guys. I'll see you Friday. Take care. Smash that follow button. Love you lots.
from me and Farmer Phil. I love you lots, guys. Stick around for the credits.
Thank you very much indeed, guys. We're going to raid. We're going to find out who we're going to raid. I'm going to raid someone outside of my circle tonight, so someone we don't know. So it's someone new. So come with me on a journey of discovery. Put my guitar down. Okay, guys, thank you. Hey, Medek, I'm sorry I missed you. Sorry, Medek, I'm sorry on his mum. I'm sorry it's the end of the night. But, you know, sorry, guys. Catch me again on Friday. What I'm going to do is we'll find someone to raid. Just bear with me, guys. Copy the raid command, please. Copy it into your chat and paste it in when we go see someone. Let's bring some forward love, forward following love into someone else's stream. I'm going to find someone who's a good streamer who's not got many people watching at the moment. We'll help them out. Let's go see Out of Control Nicole. I really like her. She does Hendrix covers and everything. She just does them on her own on electric guitar and sings. And it's really cool. If you like classic rock and stuff, she's a really cool chick. So let's go and see Out of Control Nicole, okay? Let's bring her some forward following love. Let's all go in there for a bit and say hello. And, you know, give her a follow. And because she's a cool chick and she can play. Take care on his mum. Stay with me, guys. Come on. Let's bring up the creds. Thank you so much indeed, guys. Thank you. We came, we saw, we rocked out. The raid command's going to happen in a minute. Thank you for the cheers. Thank you, Craig Fito. Thank you to my moderators, Craig Fito, Karen Morbis, Medek, and Nightbot, SiriBot, SunlistBot. They're all in there. Thank you for the new follows. Thank you, Ravenhawk, Deborah Lopes. We're going to cut to a raid any minute. Audio Rando, so Streaks a lot. Zampensky, Psycho Face, Fishy Food. Thank you so much for the raid, Psycho Face. I'll see you all Friday at 9 p.m. UK time. Don't forget to check out the Discord. We're gonna go, okay? Take care. Bye.